Taiwan is now aged society or approaching super-aging society. It's important that we find ways to stay connected with those older people. I would really encourage musicians to find meaning for themselves and to be part of the solution to what could be a problem. Music for Life is a program that brings together professional musicians and people living with dementia. Music, it's a way of connecting and communicating that is independent of words, and words are not a very easy way for them to continue to communicate anymore. And then music can be a way in which those feelings and those connections can be expressed. Express their feelings, express their emotions, to share in experiences with other people, with each other, with the musicians, and also with family.
从第一天的公开讲座就有震撼到的是，因为也有结合神经内科的吴医师，包括那个 Julian West 告诉了我们很多失智症的不同种类。
Dementia is a syndrome, so it's the name for a collection of symptoms. Signs of dementia include memory, reasoning, judgment, orientation, and perception problems. Recently, within the last 50, 60, 70 years,dementia as a specific syndrome would have been recognized as separate from mental illness.
从这几天里面，我们也都学到说，失智症其实有很多很多不同的类型跟不同的程度的等级。那都是在跟他们互动的时候，你除了基本的知识之外，怎么样去使用我们音乐的专业跟乐器，其实都有很多要学习的地方。
My aim with the local team was to really build just on their natural musicianship and the skills that they have already, to develop their improvisation skills, to share with them some ways to feel confident about using improvisation to connect with each other and also to connect with people living with dementia.
对失智症的老人，我想全世界的状况应该是都是很类似的，因为其实在英国也实地参与了他们两个工作坊，我觉得对我的震撼应该都是一样的。不管再怎么样失去 memory， 可是他在那个当下他一定会感到那个情感，这个是最重要的。
We all learnfrom each other, we learn about dementia, we learn more about each other through making music together.